Hello. My name is Deitta Rietuma, and I'm talking to you here from Latvia, where we do have the God's farm of the Baltic Sea region indigenous peoples. And this is the time of abundance. This is the time when we have everything in the gardens full of fruit and berries. And here in the bushes, we see these beautiful red currants. And it's just to pick them. It's so easy, you just take them. Here you are. Mother Nature is a generous giver. This lecture is in the series of criminalized nuclear war systems, and today I intend to deepen the subject of abundance, how we get the abundance system back in place where Mother Nature has created it. It has been taken away from most of us by fraud, organized systemic fraud. And it is not too complicated to get it back, but you and I, we are the crucial players to get it. I know how to get it back, and I tell you how to do it, and we do it together. Doesn't take much time either. First of all, we have to make a choice to start to live in our own abundance reality, to start to know our rights of abundance, to abundance, in abundance. Not to accept to live like a slave in scarcity. That is a choice, you know. That is your choice. I have made mine already. So now I'm living as Connor and loving everybody and everything. I live in a paradise of love, peace, and sometimes even understanding from others. But the most joyful thing is that I do most of the time understand others. So peace, love, and understanding is here. But of course, this is also a time of war, of imposed Cold War. And it is not enough that I do have peace in myself. I need it much more further around me than my own person. And for that, we need to create peaceful reality all around our Mother Earth and in the universe, assist its existence. And of course, the main tool there is to love. When there is abundance of love, there is peace. But this morning, when I woke up, what did I see in this bush? I saw a huge black bird with a yellow neb, you know? Blackbird sitting here and being very heavy on the branch, very full fed with the berries, and not taking one more berry. It was total abundance. And it just, the only move it could do was to empty its stomach. It couldn't even fly away. When I clapped, it just fell on the grass and scooted away. That's not what I mean with abundance for us. But to redistribute these beautiful resources we have on Mother Earth for each and everybody, and to prevent harmfulness, and to protect, to put in place such a system, it's not hard in our times of effective industrialization and absolutely marvelous communication systems. But somehow only few have access to those assets. So the question is about redistribution. That's the question. And those who have too much shouldn't sit here sort of too fed up and fat and sort of hard to move. It should be redistributed evenly. Maybe not totally evenly, but quite evenly, so everybody has enough. And still there will be so much over. But why isn't it done so? I would like to refer to my earlier lectures about that. But today I even touch on such teachers as Alex Jones in InfoWars and David Icke in David Icke's channels and books. And also on, for you English speakers, maybe not that well known, writer and researcher and filmmaker, Yuri Lina. You can find his name here. Yuri Lina. They have described very well how the system is sick and why. This is Yuri Lina's four movies, documentary videos, on a Mason grid of the wealth that has created a system that steals the wealth of nations and peoples into the pockets of few corporative networks. Yuri Lina is very good at analyzing communist, socialist scheme, and that left madness. And of course, he touches on the right madness as well, as Masonry is global and it is just divided into left and right to create illusion of choice and to create this war, ever-going war that will shock us into obedience and make us into the slaves of few. And so people get so hypnotized that they become biorobots and are even easily exterminated with various whole matrix of instruments of depopulation. So today I would like to talk about the new series of David Icke that he has published on his webpage, David Icke. If you Google it, you'll find it. And he has there one particular video where he describes the pyramidal structure, how this grid of wealth stealth is built. It's a pyramid with a Satanist eye high in the top. In his research, he is believing in the reptilian substance of that eye. Other researchers talk about Satan, which would be more in a demonic world, where people would be submitting to demonish powers without really having some aliens in behind. I personally, as a researcher, am sure that we need to open all doors and protect us against all of these powers and forces. And the weakness in the work of all three marvelous researchers, as Alex Jones, David Icke, and Yuri Lina, is following. The solution is not worked out properly. The problem is well described. The solution is missing. And here today I will provide to you exactly that, the solution. It is described in my previous work, and it's called Sun Model, Baltic Sun System Security Model. That is a compass with 14 parameters that you have always to keep in place to be protected as yourself, as your family, as bigger units, any units. All of those parameters have to be accurate to keep everything wealthy and healthy. So that concept is suggested to be empowered and put in place through groups of indigenous people in local communities as the ones that have preserved the sacred cultures and contact with the divine forces of Mother Nature. And these powers unfolding Baltic Sun System security modeling will furthermore give basic income and divine protection to everybody on our planet and even the universe. And for that, the easy method is to use the already by me declared indigenous world order and create your own indigenous banks. And that you can do by emitting your own money, your own means of exchange. Every family, each individual indeed, can emit their own money. That is how the abundance comes. And the feudal society ends. But of course not everybody knows how to do it properly, and in reality it will not be that everybody does that. You will rely on your on the people you trust. And but this system of course has to be put in place in stages without big shocks, and it has to be put by competent, reliable and loving people. Furthermore, I would like to go in today. So the very subject today that I would like to discuss is also this book. That I got quite recently in Sweden, that describes the history of the families that have created the corporations in Sweden that give them most of the wealth of resources of Sweden right now. And that is only part of why the indigenous people now are losing all their resources. This is the American situation, but these Masonic laws, global law system, are centrifuging all of the resources into the hands of few. Which is not good for those few either. It's just greedy madness. Because as system is now, it is getting self-destructive, even for these guys, the wealthy ones. So to stop this inquisitorial mass murder of planetary living systems, we have to know the corporations and the people who run them. And this book gives quite a nice insight. So let's have a look at it. Here is the book. It is in Swedish. And here is the lovely author of it, Göran Hägg. Not many of you, I guess, know Swedish. But in our region, these families are important not only for Swedes. They are important for most of us in the Baltic region. Because Swedish banks have overtaken Baltic states and there are no national banks anymore here in Latvia, and the banks that may seem national in Sweden are not national either. As I already showed my fans and scholars in the previous video from Science Academy, then a Swedish post office network was overtaken by the bank called Nordea. Nordea Bank, that has quite a wide system of owners, very many owners, so you would sort of, surely they cannot agree on there are so many that you can't trace the ownership, sort of. And the majority Sampo group is there owns just 20%. So they are so many that somebody can manipulate them. And somebody is usually the old company that runs the central banks. So it's all quite intelligently built up as a trick to fool the people. So this is a forgery, systemic forgery, where that is so complicated that you can't sort of notice when you're being fooled. But there are other banks, as SEB, that is owned by Wallenbergs, W. Wallenbergs. And when you read this book, then you start to realize most of these families are not Swedes at all. They are immigrants. And by the way, even Swedish king is Bernadotte, who came from France, because people even then thought that he would solve the problems of Swedes just because he had money. He didn't give them much money, but he came anyway and became king there in Sweden. And his wife is not Swedish either. So she comes from some industrial family that made weapons for previous wars. And when I met some big masons, they said that Sweden has been spelled since Swedish king married Sylvia from weapon industry family. So we do have to look at who is loyal to indigenous people of every local region. And usually they are not aristocracy that is established. Because the aristocracy that is established is in the grid of Christian crusade 1,000 years that have been the first global corporation that has been terrorizing the planet, colonizing it, taking it away from indigenous peoples, the resources, and getting wealthy on the resources and making the indigenous people into their slaves. As this has been going on now for almost 1,000 years, the systems are so intact that you can almost not remember how it was and what is the divine order. And that's why it is so important to keep in touch with indigenous people. And if the indigenous people in your region are already exterminated as the last Mohicans and the last Indians that I showed you the picture, then lean on the shoulders on your neighbor countries. Maybe they talk different languages. Try to trust them. Try to learn from them the methodology of contact with the forces of love, of nature, that are no more the cult of death, the war economy system that is cheerfully abundant wealth. And here is the farm where we do have the contact with the higher forces in the ancient ways that vaults have preserved. And vaults is one of the oldest languages on earth, and there are only two living languages left, and that is Lithuanian and Latvian. There was Prussian too, but that is exterminated now. But it is not language that matters at all. It is the divine energy of love. And this matrix of powers of virtue and value that I talked about. When you have parameters, then you can create abundance. So lean on the trees. They are like antennas, and each human is a living antenna, a child of the gods. And when we manifest divine order in ourselves, establishing all the parameters lovingly and sharing the resources, then the God's order comes into place in our life, and we are living in the paradise, in the divine, sacred paradise. It is quite hard to get, though, to live into the in those 14 parameters, because the whole matrix of systems that globalists have put into place is putting opposite values that are just illusions of values and tricking you to make wrong choices. And these manipulations are quite hard to notice, because they say one thing but do the other. It is organized crime of fraud that has reached all education systems. And the whole matrix of religion establishments is totally overtaken of it. If 100 years ago the churches still were talking, Christian churches, about usury and interest in banks was a sin, then you will not find such Christian banks anymore, and Christianity is no more Christian. It is covered in fraud. Here in Baltic Sea region, we don't have one, not even one single pagan sacred church. All our holy places have been overtaken by organized corporation that is hypnotizing the people in the region. And I do free you all now from all the commitments you have made to these criminal structures. You are free from them now. I do free all the Masons and all the corporative workers from your contracts. You are free from them now. And whenever you are in security and feel weak, just plug in to the Mother Nature. Be antenna that is the lion of the gods. And feel all the love of our divine creators. That is how we will succeed to nationalize the corporations and split them into useful units that will heal our planet and give all its units wealthy abundance. But let's have a look at these families that we do need to know here in the Baltic Sea region that have created these foundations that are tax-free, and they run the governments. So, I'll just read it up. Chapter 1, Carnegie. What's in a name? Company, chapter 2, Company James Dixon. 3, Brothers Kempe. 4, A. O. Wallenberg. 5, to make money on state debt, Carl G. Curbin. 6, the first Bonniers. These Bonniers, they run media. 2nd part. That describes time from 1870 to 1914. The House of Dixon's decline. The young Curbin and the last Bankire. The nobles. The Brewstroms. Axel Johnson. Second generation of Kempe. Knut Agathon Wallenberg. Family Söderberg. Carl Otto Bonniers. Time. Then the 3rd part of the book is to be but to not to be seen, and that describes the time between 1914 to 1945. And there we have the Wallenbergs again. The Brewstroms, Axon Johnson, Söderbergs and Ratos. 3rd generation of Kempe. Bonniers, Rousing, Wettje, Klicksburg and Steenbeck. And then there is the 4th part of the book that is called State and the Capital. There's a wonderful song that I love to sing in karaoke. Staten och kapitalet sitter i samma båt. Yeah. And that describes time between 1945 to 1986. And then this is the time when Wallenbergs and the wealth state of Sweden did quite marvelous achievements after they had sort of become quite wealthy on the Second World War. And Sweden was really, there was 1% unemployment just in Sweden those years. And people felt quite lucky, the Swedes, and their housing standards just rose. And then we have here also Söderbergs and their foundation capital, Wettje, the House of Brewstroms that goes down then, and the rock engineer Axelson Johnson. Bonniers in TV, H, Steenbecks, Kempes, Rousing and Tetra Pak, Ingvar Kamprad with IKEA, you know, Erling Persson, Holt and Lundin. And then the 5th part of the book is about the time from 1986 to 2012. And this is about Wallenberg's Bonniers in the digital. Axe and Johnson's Rousing in Exile. Steinbeck's Triumph. Passions. New Clothes. Kamprad, Holt, Lundin, and so on. And what this book describes is that these families is quite a conspiracy, in Sweden, that are holding the network of wealth in their frame. Of course, they are accepted to hold the network or frame by the forces behind them. If they wouldn't play the game as global military corporations, Vatican, and global Wall Street bankers desired, they wouldn't be in place either. So it is quite a grid, quite a very, very important grid of people who have really both fooled the peoples, but also being fooled themselves. Because as you read this book, you see that they are not happy people either, and they work quite hard too, and their lives, though rich in resources, they are not lives of loving people who are living in harmony with Mother Nature. And we can give even these people that. These people right now are so busy keeping others fooled and manipulating that they have lost the reality sense, how to preserve Mother Earth well and alive. But that is where indigenous people come in and the crucial ingredient. Why depopulation plans of these corporations run by these establishments cannot be accepted is the issue of nuclear waste and nuclear contamination of the planet. These people are making wars and money